Good morning all. In the last lecture, we discussed about macrostates and how to specify this particular thing. Today, we are going to discuss that in more detail. Let me start with state of a system. What could you say about state of a system? Simply, a state of a system is nothing but it's a complete description, let's say physical description of system. So what is it? So suppose I have a system and this particular system contains a very large number of particles, let's say 10 to the power of 23 particles. Now, how can I completely describe this particular system? So there are two ways in which I can do this particular thing. What I can do, I can say that, okay, what are the property of this whole system? So I can specify properties of the whole system. Now these properties may be something like what are the total number of particles, what is the temperature of this particular system, what is volume of this particular system, what is pressure of this particular system, what is total energy of this particular system. These particular parameters which describe the complete system without any reference to the individual constituent of this particular system is known as macrostates, right? So macrostate is a complete description of overall system without reference to individual constituent. So I'm not talking about what is going to happen to this particular particle, but I can also do the same thing by specifying a state of individual particles. What I mean by this particular thing? So for example, suppose the total energy of a system is, let's say, 10E, and the total number of particles are, let's say, 10 particles. Now these are the macrostates. So I can describe the system like something like this, or I can say that, okay, particle number 1, these are the number of particles, or particle number over here, and here I'm going to talk about energy. So I can say something like this, that the first particle has energy is equal to 0, the second particle has energy equal to 0, the third particle has energy is equal to E, the fourth particle has energy is equal to 3E, the fifth particle has energy is equal to 4E, the sixth particle has energy is equal to 0E, the seventh particle has energy is equal to 0E, the eighth particle has energy is equal to 1E, the ninth particle has energy equal to 1E, and the tenth particle has energy is equal to 0E. So what is the total number of particles? The total particles, there are 10 particles, and the total energy if I calculate will be E plus 3E plus 4E, so that would be 8E, 9E, 10E. So total energy is 10E. So either I can describe this particular system by overall behavior, like the total number of particles are 10E, total number of particles are 10 and the total energy is 10E, or I can specify how the individual particles are distributed. what are the energies of individual particle or what are the positions of individual particle. This particular description of individual particle is known as microstate. Because I am microscopically describing the system, that's why it is known as microstates. Now, what we are going to do, we have discussed in detail what are our macrostates. Now, in this lecture, we are going to discuss in detail about microstates. So, the next question that I am going to answer is specification of state of a system. Now this and we are going to consider about first we are going to consider quantum system. Now in quantum systems, how do we specify a state? Or if I have a system something like this, I have this particular particle in a box problem. So this is particle in 1D box problem. How can I describe this system? In other words, how can I get information about the system? What contains the information about the system, about this particular system, quantum mechanically? Quantum numbers. If I know what is the quantum number of this particular particle, then I will know what will be its wave function. So I will know what is this wave function. I can also know what is its energy, and I can predict how the wave function is going to evolve. So in quantum mechanics, a state of a system is described by a quantum number. So state of system, quantum number. But wait for a minute, what will happen if I have, let's say, one particle? This is particle in a box, 1D box problem, and I have one particle. How many quantum numbers am I going to need? One quantum number. If I have two particles, then I'm going to need two quantum numbers, one for particle number 1 and one for particle number 2. So that would be n1 n2. So these are two quantum numbers I am going to require. What if I have three particles? I'm going to need three quantum numbers. Now what is going to happen if this is a two-dimensional 2D box and there is one particle only? How many quantum numbers will be there? There will be two quantum numbers for one particle, one corresponding to nx, one corresponding to ny. So there are two quantum numbers. What is going to happen if I have two particles? Then there will be total four quantum numbers, nx for first particle, ny for first particle, nx for second particle, ny for second particle. What is going to happen if I have three particles? Then there will be six total number of quantum numbers. So nx1, ny1, nx2, ny2, nx3, ny3. And if I have n particles, then there will be 2n quantum numbers. Over here, for one dimensional case, if there is n particles, I am going to require n quantum numbers. So what I can do, I can describe a system of n particles of one dimensional box by using n quantum numbers. Over here, if it is two dimensional box, I am going to require 2n quantum numbers. What is going to happen if I the box is three dimensional, then there will be, I will require three quantum numbers, right? So if I have one particle, then there will be nx1, ny1 and nz1. If there are two particles, that would be nx1, ny1, nz1 and nx2, ny2 and nz2. What is going to happen if there are n particles? How many quantum numbers I will be requiring? I will be requiring 3n quantum numbers. Do you see some similarity in this particular thing? If I have one dimensional box, what is the degrees of freedom? For one dimensional box, 1. So the quantum numbers required will be equal to 1 DOF. So the quantum numbers required per particle required is equal to degrees of freedom of a system. For example, in two dimensional, there are 2 degrees of freedom. That's why I require 2 quantum numbers. And if I have 2 particles, then the degrees of freedom will be 4. Right? So the quantum numbers required will be equal to degrees of freedom of a system. And please note that spin is separate degrees of freedom. And why do we need quantum numbers? Why we choose this particular quantum numbers? That's because, okay, so we use quantum numbers because by knowing the quantum numbers, we can know all the parameters of a, all the properties or all the physically measurable parameters I can find out in a given time. What about the next moment? What about the further time? Suppose I know that right now I have quantum number some quantum number, so I can find out what would be the energy of a system. What will happen to that particular energy after some time? Can I predict it? Quantum mechanics padha hai na? Yes, you can predict. So by not only at a given time, uska future bhi you can predict. That's why you use quantum numbers. What about classical system? How do you specify a classical system? Classical mechanics bhi padha hai aapne. पढ़ा है ना? लैग्रेंजियन में क्या लेते हैं आप? कौन से पैरामीटर्स लेते हैं आप लैग्रेंजियन में? You require only two things, two basic quantities, position and momentum. If you know the position and momentum of a particle at a given instant, you can predict or you can find the position and momentum at later time. Right? And how do you do that? By applying the laws of quantum classical mechanics, by using classical mechanics. I am not delving into classical mechanics anymore. So for the specification of a classical system, you require position and momentum. Now suppose I have one dimensional a particle which is moving in one dimension, uska degrees of freedom kitna honga? Okay. Aur yahan pe specification ke liye mujhe kitne parameters lagenge? I require one position and one momentum. What if I have two dimensional particle? The degrees of freedom will be 2, right? And I will require q1 and q2, p1 and p2, right? Barabar hai? What about three dimensional system? Degrees of freedom will be 3, and I will require q1, q2, q3, p1, p2, p3. Or if you are not comfortable with 1, 2, 3, you can use x and y. x, y, z, because now you will realize why I have changed this particular parameter. What's going to happen if I have two particles and it is one dimensional? So you are going to q1, q2, p1, p2. Both dono ka alag alag momentum honga na, they are not related by some mean. What if I have n number of particles and this is three dimension? Qx1, Qx2, Qx3 up to Qxn. Then qy1 up to qyn. Similarly for momentum, px1 up to pxn, pyn, and pz1 up to PZN, right? So how many of these parameters, let's say coordinate axis, how many coordinates will I require if the degrees of freedom is F for generalized cases and the number of particles are N? How many such generalized coordinates will I require? This is exactly the same thing. Instead of 3, you will have F number of coordinates for each particle. So there will be F into N numbers of position coordinates. Three dimension mein hai to kitne lage mujhe? 3 into n. Yahan pe dekho, this is 1n, this is 2n, this is 3n q ke liye, qz ke liye, right? So for position coordinates I require f into n number of position coordinate, and I am going to need f into n numbers of momentum coordinates. Sorry. Clear? So total number of coordinates will be, (2fn) total number of coordinates I am going to require, right?
Now there is a simple way of specifying this system. What I can do, I can draw, let's say I'm talking about one dimension only for the time being. So I can draw the position and moment of coordinates something like this. On x-axis I have q and y-axis I have p. Right? And this particular diagram is known as phase diagram. Have you heard about this? Yes. Okay. Now this moment of position is continuous. This position is continuous. क्या हो गया? ज्यादा हो रहा है क्या? पोजीशन कंटिन्यूअस नहीं है आपका? कंटिन्यूअस है. एंड मोमेंटम, मोमेंटम, मोमेंटम भी कंटिन्यूअस है. सो व्हाट आर द पॉसिबल नंबर्स ऑफ, पॉसिबल नंबर्स ऑफ माइक्रोस्टेट्स? Since these are not discrete, the possible numbers of microstates will be infinite, right? So in order to make it easier, what we can do, we can subdivide this particular axis into some smaller portion of, let's say, width delta q, and I can divide this particular axis by smaller number of subdivision, let's say delta p. So I can say that, okay, this is 0, this is 0 plus delta q, 0 plus 2 delta q, 0 plus 3 delta q, delta p, 0 plus 3 delta p, and so on and so forth. Similarly, this is 0 plus delta q, 0 plus 2 delta q, 0 plus 3 delta q, 0 plus 4 delta q, 0 plus 5 delta q, 0 plus 6 delta q. And I'm going to subdivide it into, if I do something like this, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to divide it into cells. यहाँ पे देखो एक cells form हो गया है. हुआ है कि नहीं? And what will be the volume or area of this particular cell? The volume, and in this case it will be area, will be equal to delta p and into delta q. And what are the dimension of this? It will be the dimension of angular momentum, right? So this particular thing is known as cell. Now मैंने क्या किया है? उसको ये कर दिया है. Now I can specify that, okay, the particle is between, let's say, q and q plus delta q. I can specify something like this. So I have limited the number of possible states. जो पहले infinite थे, ये continuous होने की वजह से जो infinite था, उसको मैंने limit कर दिया है. अभी पार्टिकल यहां पे भी होगा तो भी मैं बोलूंगा कि इट इज बिटवीन, लेट मी यूज डिफरेंट कलर सो दैट इट विल बी विजिबल. अभी पार्टिकल यहां पे भी होगा तो भी मैं बोलूंगा कि इट इज बिटवीन क्यू एंड क्यू प्लस डेल्टा क्यू. यहां पे भी होगा तो भी मैं बोलूंगा इट इज बिटवीन क्यू एंड डेल्टा क्यू. यहां पे भी होगा तो भी मैं बोलूंगा इट इज बिटवीन क्यू एंड डेल्टा क्यू. करेक्ट? यू आर गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? ओके. सिमिलरली फॉर द मोमेंटम एज वेल. सो इस एरिया में अगर वो है पार्टिकल, सो आई से दैट आई कैन स्पेसिफाई द स्टेट फॉर दिस होल एरिया एज पी टू पी प्लस डेल्टा क्यू एंड क्यू टू क्यू प्लस डेल्टा क्यू. और अगर इसका एरिया मैंने डेल्टा क्यू को अगर जितना छोटा करूंगा, मैं डेल्टा पी को जितना छोटा करूंगा उतना मेरा एक्यूरेसी बढ़ेगा. बराबर है? या प्रिसीजन बढ़ेगा, एक्यूरेसी की जगह प्रिसीजन बढ़ेगा मेरा, राइट? सो आई कैन स्पेसिफाई माय स्टेट ऑफ अ सिस्टम बाय यूजिंग अ सेल. दिस इज माय स्टेट ऑफ अ सिस्टम. अगर पार्टिकल यहां पे है, उसका पोजीशन है, मोमेंटम कुछ इस तरह से है, तो आई कैन स्पेसिफाई दिस पर्टिकुलर सेल. नेक्स्ट जगह पे है तो नेक्स्ट टाइम पे, राइट? नाउ इफ आई नो दैट इनिशियली द पार्टिकल वॉज ओवर हियर, सो उसका मुझे स्टेट पता था. आफ्टर सम टाइम इट वेंट ओवर हियर, तो मुझे उसका स्टेट पता चल गया. आफ्टर सम टाइम इट वेंट ओवर हियर, आफ्टर सम टाइम इट वेंट ओवर हियर. नाउ इफ आई जॉइन दिस ऑल दिस, ये टाइम टी इज इक्वल टू जीरो पे था, टाइम टी इज इक्वल टू वन पे था, टाइम टी इज इक्वल टू टू पे था, टाइम टी इज इक्वल टू थ्री, राइट. सो अगर इफ आई जॉइन दिस ऑल पॉइंट्स, मुझे एक कुछ कर्व मिलेगा. दिस इज इन फेस स्पेस, राइट. सो मुझे पता था कि एट टाइम टी इज इक्वल टू जीरो द पोजिशन इज क्यू जीरो पी जीरो. एट टाइम टी इज इक्वल टू टी वन द पोजिशन एंड मोमेंटम आर क्यू वन पी वन. At time t is equal to t 2, the position and momentum are q2, p2. At time t is equal to 3, position and momentum are q3, p3. In sabko agar main join karunga, to mujhe kuch curve milne wala hai. This curve is known as trajectory. Samajh mein aa gaya aapko? Samajh rahe kya? Is it ज्यादा हो रहा है क्या? कुछ ज्यादा हो रहा है तो बोलो मुझे कि सर बहुत ज्यादा हो रहा है. बिकॉज दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. अगर आप ये चीजें, मैं इसको इसके ऊपर इतना टाइम इसीलिए दे रहा हूं, इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड दिस थिंग्स यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड स्टैटिस्टिकल मैकेनिक्स फॉर श्योर. देर इज नथिंग इन क्वांटम मैकेनिक्स, ओनली सिंबल्स. जब तक उन सिंबल का मीनिंग आपको समझ में नहीं आएगा, तब तक आपको कुछ समझ में नहीं आएगा. And in order to understand those symbols, you need to understand this. What is microstate? What is macrostate? And so on and so forth. So this is called as trajectory. Right? So what we have said over here, in classical system, a state of a particle or a system, state of a system can be completely described by cell in a phase space. This is how you are going to specify a state of a system in classical mechanics, for classical particle, by specifying in which cell the particle lies. What is the position and momentum, and in which cell that position and momentum is lying. समझ में आ गया? समझ में आ रहा है क्या? Okay. This is for one dimension. This is for one dimensional. I can generalize it for n dimensional space. Let's say n dimensional space, or f dimensional if you write, f dimensional plane. But can I draw it f dimensional space on a two dimensional surface? No, you have to imagine it. So there will be something like this. So there will be some position for first dimension, position for second dimension, position for third dimension, position for fifth dimension, fourth dimension, fifth dimension, sixth dimension. Similarly, there will be momentum for first dimension, momentum for second dimension, momentum for third dimension, momentum for fourth dimension, and so on and so forth. Correct? So I can use a f dimensional phase space. And in that f dimensional phase space, again I can have a f dimensional cell, something like this. If it is three dimensional, it will be something like this. If it is f dimensional, something like this will be there. There will be some cell. And now what will be the volume of this cell? Just like over here, we have volume of the cell delta p delta q. What will be the volume in f dimensional space? That will be delta q to the power f. Delta p to the power f, or I can write it to be delta p, delta q delta p to the power f. And this is for what? This is for one single particle. Now, if I increase the number of particle, let's say I have n number of particle, then I'm going to need n such volumes, small volumes for each particle. For each particle, this will be my volume. Right? So, for n particle, what will be the volume of this particular cell? The volume of that particular cell will be n into delta q delta p to the power f. This is how you are going to describe a state of a system in classical mechanics. So you need to have these many coordinates. You need to have, let's say, n into n into q to the power f into n p into q into p to the power f number of coordinates. Is it easier to specify such a huge number of coordinates? Are you with me? Okay. So, is it possible to describe such a huge number of coordinates? So, again, what I am going to do? I am going to do the same thing. I am going to label them as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on and so forth. So, one could be something like this key. I have a set of q1, q2, q3 up to qn, or q11, q12, q13 up to q1n. Then I would have q21, q22 up to qnn. q2n, and this will proceed up to qf1. QFN, right? And similarly for momentum. And यहाँ पे एक particular number रहेगा Q1 का कुछ, Q11 का कुछ number, Q22 का कुछ number, Q13 का कुछ number, Q1N का कुछ number. And for that given number, I am labeling it by some index. Let's say 1. Just like over here we did. इसके लिए हमने number दिया था 1. सिमिलरली यहां पे भी इसके लिए 1. अगर मैंने एक भी कोऑर्डिनेट चेंज कर दिया तो दैट विल बी अ डिफरेंट नंबर, और एक नंबर चेंज कर दिया दैट विल बी अ डिफरेंट नंबर. यू आर गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? सो अगेन देयर विल बी अ ह्यूज नंबर्स ऑफ पॉसिबल states, and these particular states, all of these individual 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, jo kuch main likhne wala hu, these are my micro states. So, micro state samaj mein aa gaya? Questions. Yes, combination भी बहुत सारे रहेंगे, उसको निकालने में भी प्रॉब्लम होने वाला है. हाँ, yes, उसमें भी बहुत कंफ्यूजन होगा. दैट्स ट्रू. उसी लिए तो हम यहाँ पे सेल यूज कर रहे हैं. हाँ, तो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन की योर रिक्वायरमेंट. व्हाट आर योर रिक्वायरमेंट? एक्यूरेसी कितनी चाहिए उसके ऊपर. सो व्हाट आई कैन डू कि मैं बोल सकता हूँ कि ओके, फ्रॉम पोजीशन 1 टू पोजीशन लेट्स से 10 मीटर, दिस इज माय फर्स्ट सेल. फ्रॉम पोजीशन लेट्स से 10 मीटर टू 20 मीटर सेकंड सेल, पोजीशन 20 टू 30 थर्ड सेल एंड सो फॉर. सो ये I can do something like this, or I can even do something like this ki position 0 to 1 micrometer, one cell. Meri system ki requirement kya hai, us hisab se main usko karunga. Right? And what we are going to do, we are not going to actually find these particular things. Ultimately, we are going to represent it in some formula. Just like, let's talk about quantum mechanical case. Suppose I have 10 to the power 23 particles with me, and I want to fill up it something like this. This is E0, E1, E2, E3, and there are one particle in E0, and all the remaining particles are in E1. What are the number of ways? What are the possible number of microstates? I don't need the details of microstate. What I will be requiring? I will be requiring number of microstates. Konsi microstate hai? It doesn't matter. Yahan pe particle number 1 hai, ya 2 hai, ya 3 hai, ya 4 hai. I am not going to worry about it. Because yahan pe agar particle number 1 hai, baki remaining yahan pe hai, toh that's a different microstate. यहाँ पे पार्टिकल नंबर 2 है और रिमेनिंग यहाँ पे है तो दैट्स अ डिफरेंट माइक्रोस्टेट. यू कैन स्पेसिफाई इट बाय लेट्स से दिस इज n इज इक्वल टू 0, दिस इज n इज इक्वल टू 1. सो 0 1 1 1 दिस इज माइक्रोस्टेट नंबर 1. द सेकंड माइक्रोस्टेट कुड बी 1 0 समथिंग लाइक दिस. द थर्ड माइक्रोस्टेट कुड बी 1 1 0 समथिंग लाइक दिस. एंड देयर विल बी वेरी लार्ज नंबर ऑफ माइक्रोस्टेट्स, मगर वो उसके डिटेल्स मुझे पता करने की जरूरत नहीं है, बिकॉज आई नो मैं उसको मेजर नहीं कर सकता हूं. यू आर गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? मुझे क्या चाहिए? आई जस्ट रिक्वायर द नंबर. एंड हाउ आई कैन फाइंड आउट दोज नंबर? यू हैव ऑलरेडी डन दैट. दिस विल बी 10 टू द पावर 20. नॉट नंबर ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेट्स भी निकालने की जरूरत नहीं है फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम. फॉर्मूला हमने देखा है ना, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट पॉसिबल कॉन्फिगरेशंस, इन हाउ मेनी वेज यू कैन रिप्रेजेंट दिस पर्टिकुलर कॉन्फिगरेशन. दैट वुड बी 10 टू द पावर 23 फैक्टोरियल इनटू 1 फैक्टोरियल इनटू 10 टू द पावर 23 माइनस 1 फैक्टोरियल. And that would be equal to 10 to the power 23 into 10 to the power 23 factorial divided by 1 factorial into 10 to the power 23 minus 1 factorial. That would be 10 to the power 23. हेलो, करेक्ट. सो दिस विल गेट कैंसल एंड आई एम गोइंग टू हैव 10 टू द पावर 23 पॉसिबल वेज. हेलो, अभी आ रहा है क्या? पता नहीं, इंटरनेट का कुछ प्रॉब्लम हो. सो एनीवे, वी आर एट द एंड. सो दिस इज द नंबर ऑफ वेज दैट आर पॉसिबल, 10 टू द पावर 23 वेज. वो कौन से है मुझे देखने की जरूरत नहीं है इंडिविजुअली. सो नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग पार्ट इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. थैंक यू फॉर योर टाइम.